Hi friends, welcome back to this React.js Advanced Concept series. In the last video, I have explained about use ref hook in depth. In this video, I am going to talk about use context in depth. Let's start. Use context is a hook that allows us to maintain a global state within our React application. It provides us a way to share data between components without prop drilling. Prop drilling, what is that? Let me explain that first. I have this application. Here I have a first level component. Inside that I have a second level component. And inside that I have a third level component. In the third level component, I have a message. And in the first level component, I have a button. When I click this button, this message should be updated. Let me show you in the code level. In index.js, I'm having the first level component. In the first level component, I'm having the second level component, and in the second level component, I'm having the third level component. Also, in the first level component, I'm having a state which is having an initial value. I am updating this value on clicking this button. Also, I'm passing this message to the second level component through props. In the second level component, I am receiving this props and then passing this to the third level component through props. In the third level component, I am receiving this props and showing here. That is why if I am clicking this button, this message is getting updated. Okay, if you see in the second level component, we are not at all using this props anywhere. But even though we are not using this props, we need to receive this props from the first level component and pass that to the third level component. This is called props drilling. And this is not a good design in React. We should avoid props drilling. We can use useContext to address this. Let me show you. In index.js, let me use this component instead of first level component. Here also, the setup is same. In level 1 component, we have the level 2 component, and in the level 2 component, we have the level 3 component. And in the level 1 component, we have the button, and in the level 3 component, we have the message. But this time, I am not passing through props. So there is no connection. For now, let me declare an empty message. So we will not see any message and update will not work. Okay, let's implement useContext here. First we need to create a context. Let me create a new file. I can create a context using the createContext function from React. Then I need to create a provider function. In the provider function, let me return the provider from the context we created. And let me get the props, and here let me give props.children so that when we wrap any component with this provider, that component and all the children component inside that component will have the same context. Let me also copy this state into this context and let me pass this as value. Now let me go to the index.js and wrap this component inside the provider from the context we created. So now this level 1 component and all the children components will share the same message context. Now in the level 1 component, instead of useState, let me use useContext. To this, let me give the message context. So when I click this button, this message will be updated, which will be updated in the message context. Now in level 3 component, I can use the useContext to get the value, like this. Now we can see the initial value here, and when I click this button, we can see this message is getting updated. This is because whenever a state in the context is changed, a re-render will be triggered in all the components those consume the respective context. This is how we can use useContext to share data between components and avoid props drilling. This useContext simplifies state management for complex applications and also improves code readability and maintainability. Even though useContext has good benefits, we should not use useContext always. First, we should understand how context updates work and impact performance. Context updates can have a significant impact on application performance, especially in large-scale applications with many components consuming the same context. When a context value changes, React triggers a re-render of all components that are directly or indirectly consuming that context. This means that even components deep within the component tree can be re-rendered, potentially leading to unnecessary work. If a context is used extensively throughout our application, even a small change to its value can trigger a cascade of re-renders, potentially impacting performance. In large-scale applications, context updates can become performance bottlenecks if not managed carefully. Excessive re-renders can affect the overall user experience. There are situations where we have to avoid using the context. If the data only needs to be shared between a few sibling or parent-child components, it's better to lift the state up to the closest common ancestor and pass it as props, rather than introducing context. If the data doesn't change often, passing it through props is simpler and more performant. Using context for static data may introduce unnecessary complexity. When managing state that is localized to a specific component, for example form state, useState is a better choice. Context is overkill for such cases. For larger applications where we have to maintain a complex global state, it is better to choose state management libraries like Redux, which provide more structure, optimization, and scalability when compared to context. After analyzing all these, and if we find out context is the best choice for our application, we can use the context. But when we use context, we need to follow some best practices. In larger applications, instead of creating a single context and having all our states in that, we can split the context into multiple contexts. For example, we can have all our authentication related states in a separate context called auth context, and all our theme related states in a separate context called theme context. This way, updating the theme won't affect the components that only consume the auth context. Instead, if we store both authentication related states and theme related states in a single context, any change in any part of the context triggers re-renders for all consumers. Okay, let me also show you how we can have multiple contexts in a shopping cart application. In a shopping cart application, we might want to separate the state related to the cart items, user authentication, and product information into distinct contexts. So while creating the context, we can create separate contexts like this. Now we need to provide the context. For that, we can wrap one context over another, something like this. And while consuming, we can consume the required context alone in each component, like this. By carefully considering the structure of our application, we can effectively use multiple contexts to create a well-organized and scalable state management solution. There are also other optimization techniques like using useMemo, useCallback, ReactMemo, etc. when working with context. We will see them in separate videos. Hope you like this video. That's all for today. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.